going to learn about how to calculate translation and rotation deflection in Ansys, mechanical workbench. Assume that we have a task like this. When we have a beam that is constrained from one side and free in the other side, we have to calculate the deflections, the translation and rotation deflections in point B, where we apply the force F with 100 newtons. The distance between point A, where we apply the constraint, and point B, where we apply the force, is 100 millimeters. The cross section of this beam is square with 5 millimeters length for all of its sides. The materials that we are going to use is aluminium alloy with a Poisson rate of 0.33. And we are going to leave Ansys meshing properties at default. So, first of all, we go to any CAD software we know, SolidWorks, Fusion, Inventor, whatsoever. And here I work with Fusion. We design the beam. We make sure all dimensions are correct. The 100 millimeter between A and B, and the length of the side is 5 millimeters extruded. And then we have to export this type of CAD files to be as a STIP. From here, export STIP files, because Ansys can import STIP files. After that, we move to the workbench of Ansys. We start a new static structural study. First of all, we have to assign the materials. We have to find the aluminium alloy. So we double click on engineering data. We have structural steel as a default. We are looking for aluminium alloy. We go to engineering data sources, general materials. And here we can find aluminium alloy. We make sure that Poisson rate is correct. We can see here that Poisson rate is correct. We add the aluminium alloy to our study. Then we close this tab. After that, we have to import the geometry. We can design here geometry, but it's Ansys is a finite element, is a dynamic analysis, thermal analysis. I prefer to use a CAD software. So we are going to import geometry for our beam. You can find it here. Then we open the model, the study. Then after the Ansys Mechanical Enterprise opened, we go to the geometry properties. We change the assignment of the materials from steel to aluminium alloy. After that, we check on the meshing properties. All properties are in default. We update the mesh. After that, we are going to make or insert a new remote point that we are going to compute its deflection, translation, and rotation deflections on all axes. Here we have to assign a remote point. I'm going to turn on the node, and I choose this side to be the free side where we are going to apply our force. Here it is, the point that we are going to choose, apply. I'm going to name it as B. Then we begin the static structural analysis settings. First of all, by adding a fixed support, we add it to the other side. The whole face is constrained. Apply it. Then we will apply a remote force. The remote force are going to apply in the same point, in the same remote point where we are going to compute our results. So scoping method will be changed to remote point. Assign to remote point to B. And then we have to define the magnitude defined by component. The force is in the negative y direction with a magnitude of 100 newtons. After that, we are going to add the deformation total to calculate it. Then we go back to our remote point. We insert a command, which is my pilot. Equals in pilot, which is a specific point that we are going to calculate deflections at. Close the remote point, then we go to the solution and insert a command. The commands that we are going to insert here is to calculate the translation and rotation deflections in this specific point, which we has named my pilot. And you can see here, the codes, the line of codes, which is to get the translation deflection in this node, which is the end pilot, or my pilot, the remote point B. And we have here to convert the radians to degrees to get the accurate results. And you have to check if your units are correct here by opening this tab. If you are using the metric system, the US customary system, degrees, whatever. After that, we are going to make Ansys to solve our task. Now let's take a look at the total deformation simulation. And we can see here that the maximum deflection happened in the free side where we applied our force. And we are going to check where has the maximum deflection occurred. And we can see here that the maximum deflection has happened in the remote point where we apply the force, which is correct. Yep, the simulation is correct. After that, we are going to check the values for the rotational and translation deformation. We go to commands. We can find it at results tab. And here we can check the values. Let's reopen the PDF file, the task file. So the translation deflection on x-axis with the same value is correct, with y-axis is correct, with z-axis is correct, and the sum of them is correct, 8.98, which is the maximum deflection in the model. So if we applied a torque rather than the force, we are going to have some rotational displacement or deflections in the point. Thank you for watching.